I actually can't see a fucking thing in this thing. Pool floaty.
I was not allowed to play video games growing up. I had a pretty strict upbringing. Wasn't allowed to watch television or play video games. Ironically, two things that take up most of my adult life. Uncharted 4 is a top 10 game. If you don't agree, you are sadly mistaken. Look at this view. The first game that I performed in was Far Cry 4. Nobody understood how much it meant to me. I would like show up every day and I'd be like, I'm so happy to be here. And people were like, yeah, okay. I just don't think anybody understood that I was like a proper gamer who played all of the Far Cries. So I did Far Cry 4, only voiceover, and then we're doing full performance capture for Battlefront 2. I have no gun, I have no gun. What happened, Nathan? Where'd it go? Being a part of Star Wars, it's crazy. I can't believe I get to be a part of it. This isn't just a game, this is a canon character in the Star Wars galaxy. The internal process for performance capture is exactly the same as what you would do as an actor. The technical aspect of it is obviously very different, and even just your day, like rationing your energy, is very different. In a motion capture day, you do not stop. There's no lollygagging with your castmates, let's run lines or let's take this Instagram. There's none of that nonsense can happen. A video game is more physical than what I would do on a normal TV set because things need to be exaggerated for the dots to get picked up. But on camera, I would look like a crazy person. Oh, Nathan Drake. The games industry has evolved into so many different facets. There are a lot of really, really great games where it's not like, it's not that at all. And I'm also just more interested in a sweeping epic adventure. I'm not like tribal about my consoles. You can like more than one thing, you're allowed. I took a plane ride over here yesterday from the East Coast. I played Oxenfree on my iPad until I finished it. I played Kentucky Route Zero on my Surface Pro. So I'm on a plane with multiple devices playing different things. It's not just like, oh, but this laptop is my gaming laptop. No, like I'll play on anything, especially because some of the most interesting games that are coming out are really small 2 to 4 hour experiences that you can play on the go. If you are just about your Xbox, if you are just about your PlayStation, you're missing out on a plethora of games, and I feel bad for you. So, we are going to play Keep Talking and Nobody Explodes. This is a bomb diffusing game. You're gonna have the bomb diffusing manual. Okay. You cannot look at my screen, I cannot look at the manual. Okay, ready? Big breath. 5 minutes on the clock.
Is there more than one red wire?
No.
Is there more than one yellow wire?
No.
Okay, cut the second one.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, I don't know what this thing is called, but it's got a big box with a number on it, and then four things. It's like a memory thing.
Four, press the button in the same position as you press the game one.
Okay.
Press the button.
Wait. The big number is one.
Big number is one. Press the button with the same label you press the stage game.
That number's four. I've already forgotten it. Last number is a two.
Press the button with the same label you press the stage game.
I think it was a two. Ha! Yes! The games industry will only get stronger and stronger as the technology catches up to the brilliant minds that are working in it. That's the thing that's exciting about it. You know, and I'm much more fulfilled, me and millions of other people, we're just much more fulfilled by games than going to the movies. Ooh, ah! I just died.